There's been a lot of talk about ABC compulsory iView accounts recently. The purpose of this video is to explain that the compulsory accounts are only a small part of the story. Most of the story is about data sharing without consent. When I say data sharing, I mean telling a bunch of third parties like Facebook and Google exactly what you're watching all the time. My name's Vanessa Teague. I'd like to thank Chris Culnane and Kathy Reed for their technical work on this investigation. I don't just want to tell you what's happening. I want to show you how to examine and investigate it yourself. I'm using the Chromium browser today, although usually I use Firefox. But Firefox blocks all the creepy little tracking scripts that I want to describe. So here in Chromium, if you click on these three little dots in the top right corner and go down to Developer Tools, you can start looking at what your browser is sending and receiving from everywhere you go on the internet. Let's go to iView. And let's see what iView is instructing our browser to send to whom. First, we'll look at what they're sending to Google in particular. And the first thing you notice is that there's a whole lot of information going to places that are not just the ABC. Here's Google. And this is a great long list of other companies, most of which you've probably never heard of. It includes Facebook, it includes Tealium, it includes a lot of survey and other tracking scripts. Today I'm going to choose to watch Sean McAuliffe's Mad as Hell, for which I have great sympathy for reasons that I trust will soon become apparent. As you can see, more and more information is getting sent, which as you can see is on the one hand is reasonable, because I'm requesting more and more things, but it's not reasonable that it's being sent to a whole lot of other third parties that I didn't know. I'm going to watch Series 4, Episode 4. Let's go back to looking at what's being sent to Google this time as I log in and start watching this particular episode. As I look, I see right here in this last message, this is the message that my web browser was instructed by iView to send to Google. And I see a lot of tremendous detail about what I've just watched. First of all, you can see right here that it clearly tells Google not just the show I'm watching, but exactly the precise episode. Here it says Series 14, Episode 4. If that's not enough for you, it gives Google this exact URL that if you copy it into a web browser at home, I guarantee it's exactly the URL of exactly the show I just watched. So all this discussion around iView compulsory login has had a fair bit of public opposition, and it's been responded to with a whole lot of discussion about how important privacy is and so forth. Here's a copy of the FAQ that the ABC recently put out. If we scroll down to the bottom, we see this question: if I log into an ABC iView account with a Google email address, does Google have access to my iView viewing, my ABC viewing data? The answer given here is no, but I've just shown you that the answer is clearly yes, regardless of whether or not you've used a Google email address to log in. So now let's look at what happens when I've logged in. I've got lots of different iView accounts. Here's one of them. We're going to run this one today. Let's watch what information gets sent to third parties when I'm logged in to my ABC account while I watch iView. Today I'm going to watch the immortal Canberra Bubble episode of Four Corners, which I've already watched before, but I'm watching again for demonstration purposes. This was the immortal episode that first raised serious allegations of sexual coercion and assault by a senior member of the cabinet. So who gets to find out that I'm watching this? Let's look at what gets sent to Google again. I've already showed you that Google gets precise details of exactly what I watched. That hasn't changed. And you can see here it is again. Series 2020 inside the Canberra bubble. One of the many companies you've probably never heard of is a company called Tealium. Let's look at what gets sent to Tealium when I watch this episode of Four Corners, when I'm logged in to iView. First of all, they get pretty much the same information that Google got. That is exactly the specific episode that I was watching. But if we scroll down, we see a little bit more detail that Tealium's getting this time too. Here, further down, you see this interesting little parameter called user email SHA-256. If you have a certain kind of personality, you can go and double check that this is exactly the SHA-256 hash of the email address that I used or that you used. The thing you need to know is that this is not any kind of reasonable privacy protection at all. So not only is Tealium getting the detailed description of exactly what I'm watched, but this hash of my email address is no reasonable privacy protection at all. You might as well just be sending the plain old email address that identifies you, because any recipient that already knows or can guess your email address can easily recover that identifying information from the hash. So let's just summarize what we know. We know that when we're not logged in, Google is immediately sent the precise details of exactly what we watched. And we know that when we are logged in, that still gets sent to Google and also to Tealium. And Tealium also gets a very weakly obfuscated version of our email address that's easily recovered by anybody else who can guess what it is. So everything about the security of this data depends crucially on what Tealium does with this information and whether they're allowed to share it or sell it onwards or integrate it with other data. We don't know what that arrangement with ABC management is. I requested the data sharing arrangement under Freedom of Information via the righttoknow.org website, but the request was refused. We know that the data sharing arrangement exists, but the precise details or even the vague idea of what's in it remains a secret. All we can do to guess what's in it is have a look at Tealium's own advertisements about who they are and what they do. Here's their website. They brag about being able to integrate their data with Facebook, but also with Google and a lot of other advertisers. It says you can use high quality first party data to improve your Facebook advertising analytics. In other words, the specialty here is not just to acquire data about individuals, but to link those profiles across different domains. For example, linking your ABC viewing history with the rest of your Facebook profile. We don't know for sure that that's what the data sharing arrangement with Tealium actually allows, but we know that that's what the company does as their business. But this doesn't matter because you can opt out of the data sharing, can't you? Let's have a look at what happens when I go into my account and specifically and deliberately opt out of all of the data sharing options that are here. I want no personalized recommendations. I want no promotions on digital platforms. I've turned off every option that is available here in my account. There is not a single thing I have failed to say no to here. But if you read the fine print, you'll notice that actually none of these options promise to stop sharing the data. That's a good thing, because look what happens even after we've turned those options off. I'm going to watch bananas in pyjamas today because children's privacy matters too. Let's watch what happens when a kid watches bananas in pyjamas after their parents have specifically turned off all of the data sharing opt-outs that they can manage. Oh look, Google still gets exactly the same precise description of exactly what's being watched. And Tealium still gets, exactly the same detailed description of exactly what's being watched, and also the hash of our email address again. So this opt-out, as far as I can tell, is not stopping anything. There is no opt-out here. There are simply some options that make it look a little bit as if you had an opportunity to stop the data sharing, but even after you have chosen to opt out, the data sharing still continues. So why should you care? Why does it matter whether Google and Facebook and Tealium find out what TV shows you've been watching online? Well, to some people, it does matter. If you're a person in a conservative family who's exploring your sexuality, if you're an immigrant from an authoritarian country who wants to watch what your government from back home is up to, if you're a public servant who's interested in exposing corruption, then there are many situations in which the exposure of this interest of yours might actually have very negative consequences for you as an individual. But there's actually a much more important aspect of this situation, which is that en masse, particularly in an election year, information about Australians and our preferences and thoughts conveyed to the large tech companies that make money out of selling our attention for a buck can be used for political manipulation on a large scale. We've already seen this directed against other democracies, and we'd be crazy to think it wouldn't happen here. If you haven't read this wonderful article from the MIT Technology Review called How Facebook and Google Fund Global Misinformation, I strongly recommend it. It describes how the rise of electoral manipulation that destroys democracies is directly related to the design of platforms that use algorithms to target advertisements exactly to people based on data about that person. It requires exactly the same algorithms for targeting things to people according to people's known weaknesses and preferences. And the more information that Google and Facebook and related platforms can amass about us, the more effectively they can sell our attention to political, foreign, or domestic advertisers who tell us exactly what we want to hear. Of course, this is particularly important in an election year. By handing over the detailed viewing preferences of millions of Australians, we're exposing our democracy to the threat of political manipulation on a massive scale. Of course, that risk was already there, but for a trusted organisation like the ABC to be actively adding to it, particularly without actually informing everybody of what they were doing, is unconscionable. I want to conclude by saying how much I love the ABC, how crucially important it is to Australian democracy to have this wonderful resource of good quality journalism willing to criticise and question some of the most powerful individuals and organisations in the world. I don't want people to stop watching. I want the ABC management to stop disclosing the data so that 25 million Australians can take advantage of this wonderful resource without having their preferences and viewing habits tracked and recorded and disclosed to third-party advertisers across the world.